What's up, you guys? What's up? It's just getting more Randy. How you doing today? I hope you are blessed and well. Thank you so much for being here. Hey, you guys, how you doing? What's up?
Thank you so much for being here, you guys. I'm just being extra over the top because I'm trying to stay cool. But it's super hot out here today, so I'm not going to hold you long. You notice my videos have been a little shorter these last few videos because, you guys, it's in the 100 degrees here in Zone 7, Richmond, Virginia, and I want to stay safe, and I want you guys to stay safe as well. And making these videos in the middle of the day after work, I can't be out there in that heat, so I can make some quick, short ones, and hopefully it helps you out. Okay, you guys, so let's just jump right into the video. Oh, by the way, if you're new to my channel, welcome to Gardening with Skinny Boy Randy, where beginners and experts are always welcome. We love having you guys here. Thank you so much for being here. So, don't forget, click a thumbs up, thumbs down, just another 2 minute thing. Okay, I love you guys just a minute. Uh-oh, I think we got a bug trying to crawl into our video. Yeah, we had a bug. I got him. So yeah, you guys, what can you plant right now? Zone 7, Richmond, Virginia, or if you're in like 6, 7, maybe some 8, but here are my tips for you. We're not professionals, you guys. You know, we don't proclaim to be, but we just like to put out tips that help us and possibly will help you in your garden journey. Thank you so much for being here, you guys. I hope you caught the CBS Channel 6 news special, local news here in Richmond, Virginia, who did an interview on me about gardening and how it's affecting and helping people's mental health, you guys. I feel so honored and blessed that they came out to the Skinny Boy Farms and did this amazing interview. I'll try to leave the link in the description box. It was amazing. So let's just jump right into it. If you have not already done so, start you some sugar baby watermelons right now. Yeah, I wouldn't suggest trying to grow the big, huge watermelons unless you have a long run season, but you can get some sugar babies and some other varieties in the ground now that only take about 100 days. Okay, our first frost is not expected until October the 22nd, somewhere up in there. And so today, we're just at July 25th. So, you know, you go from July 25th, August 25th, September 25th, you know, so on and so forth. So we have about 3 more months worth of growing time. So I always tell you guys, succession plant. Keep getting harvest. If you planted your squash early in the year and you're wondering, oh, they're dying out, or you may have tons of squash bugs. Sometimes starting your squash and zucchini early, it gives the squash bugs time enough to find you and try to eat you out of house in the squash, okay?
Okay, and we ain't got time for that. Anybody got no money? Anybody got any money to be buying no more squash?
You should already have some more seeds though, hopefully. But yeah, I've been succession planning as you've seen in my previous videos. But yeah, it's not too late to get you some sugar baby watermelons in the ground. Also, plant you another round of cucumbers, you guys. Yes, cucumbers only take about 80 days tops, you know. Plant you some more cucumbers. Just let them keep growing into the frost, okay? So don't think it's too late to plant your cucumbers. Also, get you some more beans going. Get you some more bush beans or pole beans, preferably bush beans because they grow a little faster and the beans will, you know, form quicker than if you did the pole beans. But if you don't have a choice and you want to try the pole beans, go ahead and try the pole beans. They'll work just as well. Also, sprinkle you some cilantro around your garden. If you have patches of empty space, put you some cilantro seeds down. Yes, it's extremely hot for cilantro, but if they tend to bolt and go to flowering, they're just going to go to seed, which is going to give you some coriander, which is a great spice to use as well. Also, get you another round of squash and zucchini in the ground, y'all. You know when you planted yours last time, it didn't take that long, so get you some in the ground now. It will take the same amount of time, and we have all this good heat, so just keep them well watered. If you can put mulch around them, that'd be great, but if you can't, just keep them well watered and try to plant them in a semi-shade and sun area so they don't burn out, you guys, okay?
Okay!
Also, get you some more corn in the ground. It's not too late to succession your corn. Start you some corn seeds on your patio or your deck in some cups or whatever. Transfer them out into the ground when they're about 3 or 4 inches tall. You'll have some more corn in a few days. You've seen my corn, and we have tasseling, and we have new ears starting to come out. So yeah, get you some more corn in the ground, you guys. Also, don't forget your flowers. It's not too late to plant you some zinnias in the ground. They germinate fairly quickly and they flower fairly quickly. And so we're still trying to attract all the bees that we can attract, you guys, okay? So still plant you some more zinnias. So I just wanted to give you a few tips on things. I'm not going to go in detail about getting ready for fall just yet because that's a whole nother video. But I just wanted to give you some ideas of some things that you can still plant right now out in your garden late July. Okay, you guys, I love you guys. You're the best. Don't forget, click like and subscribe. Thumbs up, thumbs down. Just not your two middle fingers, okay? Okay, and it's getting hot out here, y'all. I ain't trying to fall out because you know I fall out. And I'm back. Don't forget, live, love, laugh, you guys. Grow stuff and eat it. You're the best.